So Tommy, here we are again. It feels like a while since we've done it with no midweek game, but how have the lads been in training this week?
Yeah, we had a good week. We had a behind closed doors game up at Wickham for the lads who haven't played as much over the last week or so, or a couple of weeks or so, I should say. And that was a really worthwhile exercise. Matt put out a really strong side up there. We had a real mixture, and it was good for us to get a look at a lot of our youngsters as well. So it's been a really good week, obviously, on the back of another win last weekend. We were delighted to get over the line with the Kidderminster game, having had such a euphoric week the week before. It's statistically very, very difficult to repeat that sort of thing, but to get the 3 points was a real positive for us.
But that's it, isn't it? The depth of this squad has been something that's had to be worked around this season with a few long-term injuries. So is it good to have those opportunities to get the minutes in and for those players to maybe give you a thought or two ahead of the weekend game?
Yeah, I mean, that's why we put the game on. It's to get them up to as much as we can, close to match situation. We can always put in-house games on, with the youngsters and stuff, but to go somewhere else and make it a real game with officials and stuff just gives it that little bit more competitive edge. But everybody who took part in the game, for one reason or another, impressed us, whether it was their fitness levels or we were having a look at them for the first time as youngsters. It was, like I said, all the staff were there, Terry, Matt, we all came up and watched. So it was a good day, apart from the weather.
And, that's probably not going to change, is it? The weather's not great at the moment, but that's something that everyone has to deal with. And something else that everyone has to deal with, obviously, is the travel. So that's one of the big things when going up to Rochdale. But, they're going to be a tough challenge as it is. So things like that don't really come into it, do they?
Well, we're prepped being as it would be for any game that we know we're going to stay overnight on the Friday. So we'd still train on Friday morning at the training ground before eating and leaving to go up and stay in Rochdale. So it's part of the game. We're in a national league, as the title suggests. So you're going to have to go. And I think we've got about 8 or 9 overnights in the season. So it's probably one of the top end for a club in this division. But it's part and parcel of the game. We look forward to the game.
Of course, they're one of the sides that came down last year. We've already seen this so far this season, what the challenge that can bring with Hartlepool, but that was one we overcame in. So does that give you confidence that we can be amongst those teams?
Yeah, I mean, they've had a reset. Coming out of the EFL is a huge blow to any football club and town. But I think Jim's doing a really good job there. They've got a very good brand of football. They've got some really good players who I'm aware of and I've been aware of for many seasons. So we're looking forward to it. I think it'll be a good game of football, but ultimately both teams want to get a positive result. We go there, with a point in your pocket. We want to try and add to that. If we can't, then we'll try and bring that point home. So we're in a good place ourselves as a group. I think the training ground's been really bubbling and buzzing place over the last few weeks. And, we want to keep that going. It's as simple as that. We're trying to stay on the crest of a wave. We started November really, really well, and we want to try and continue it into the middle.
And one of the casualties on Saturday was Theo. It's obviously a position we don't want to see more injuries with obviously Ethan Burnett and Stuart O'Keefe currently on the sidelines. So do we know any more on Theo's case at the moment?
Well, he's getting looked at, so we haven't had any definitive time frame stuck on it. But if you were a betting man, you'd probably bet he wouldn't be available for this weekend. But that makes somebody else's opportunity, going to arise. When a door shuts on someone, it opens for another person. Hence the reason we tried as best we can to get everybody up to speed to be available to be picked. But, we've had options in there who are available to me straight away. And Dejan and Tommy Willard both have done really good jobs when they've been asked to in that role. So it's not such a worry for me. I think we've got a really, versatile group. We've got one or two positions that we know we've got 3 or 4 lads who can sort of float around in different areas, so we're quite fluid, and you won't see any new faces before the weekend anyway.
Hadji will be missing as well, but that's one of the positions where we have a lot of strength in that area, so is that a bit less of a headache, that one?
Well, we had a plan for that one before. Yeah. We knew he was going to go off and play for Tanzania, so that's a positive from our point of view. He's obviously doing well enough while he's playing for Aldershot Town to be able to keep getting called up for his national team. So that's a feather in his cap. Obviously it's something we'd rather him not be missing, but we've got a bit of depth in that area, so again, it's somebody else's opportunity. He's certainly not going to be here for the next 2 games, and it's up to somebody to put their flag out there and make a claim for his position.